Praise the Lord. So we many of the times do raise this question. Why my mind always thinks of evil? Even after my confessing my sin, even after repenting for my sin, how the evil thoughts come and attack my mind, and what am I supposed to do? We read in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 13. One day, the Master gave this incident that a king sowed good seed in his field. And we read in Matthew chapter 13, verse 25, the servants coming and asking the Master, "Master, we sowed good seed, but how is it that along with the wheat, weeds also coming?" In the mind, some people do come with good thought, "I went to sleep, but I could not sleep at night. My mind was with all kinds of thoughts, all kinds of evil attacks, and I could not sleep. And even something which I have forgotten long ago, all that is coming and attacking my mind. What shall I do? From where do they come?" So they came and asked the Master, "Master, we sowed a good seed. Now how is it that weeds have come up? And still worst, the weeds are growing stronger than the wheat. So what shall we do?" Then the Master said, "Hello, my dear, while you are sleeping, while you are not alert to what's happening to your mind, because you do not know the truth. The truth is, as we read in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 4, God of this age, Satan, he doesn't want the children of God to receive the word of God, to receive the mercy of God, to receive the grace of God, and to develop it. So whatever they have received from God, maybe they went to the retreat, maybe they committed, maybe they made a promise to the Lord, maybe they made the way of the cross, whatever may be, that should not remain in their mind. Just they should listen, they should feel good, and with that it should go away. So there is an enemy who doesn't want that God's presence and God's anointing to go deep into man. So he comes while we are asleep. He takes it away, pulls it away, and goes away. So he doesn't want, and he works on the minds of human being. He brings some other thoughts. He brings some other incidents. He brings something that disturbs you, that you forget what you have learned yesterday. You forget what the Lord has spoken to you. You forget what the commitment you made to God. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So God of this age, he blinds the minds of human being by working on the human minds. So what we are supposed to do? That's why we read in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 9 says, your mind is like a field. So whatever seed we sow, it will sprout. So our mind is like a field. So if we put good, it will sprout. If we put bad, it will sprout. If somebody discourages you, you will get discouraged. Somebody speaks, you are in a good mood. Suddenly somebody says something, immediately you become different. You get upset. Instead of the presence in you moving you to handle the moments of your day, the situation of your life, he allows the situation of your life to handle you. Today you have to go to marriage, you prepare well. You act as you are really happy, forget about something. Somebody you have to meet, so you put up nice smile, please come, come. So according to the situation, you see somebody is not well, you are few minutes you are happy, you are gone. Instead of you carry the Lord to every moment, every circumstances, the Lord has trusted me and He is in me, I am His, so I carry Him. Whether it is a marriage or a dead place or a situation, the good or bad, I carry Him. I am on a mission. I am sent on a mission. I have come to this earth on a mission. And my God is in me. He has made my heart His temple. And He has chosen me even before I am born. Instead, the enemy makes the circumstances to rule my life, the people to rule my life. So my mind is constantly attacked by the enemy. That's why whatever it is sowed, that will sprout in your mind. Our mind is a field. That's why St. Paul says from the book of Ephesians chapter 6 verse 12, we are not fighting with people with the flesh and blood. Suddenly you are happy, you're doing, your wife comes and says, what have you earned? Nothing is there at home. Waste, you are doing job. You are really working hard. You are trying to build up your business. Suddenly your wife comes and says something. Your spirit is put off. The Bible says, Proverbs 18 and 14 and 17, 22, that once you are entering into depression, you allow the sad thought to enter into you, it will even dry up your bones. The sad thought, 17:22 says, it will dry up even your bones. You can't walk anymore. Many people today have various kind of sickness because of depression, sadness. The things that they don't desire is happening to them. They do not know how to handle them. Instead of carrying the Lord with us, focusing on Him, focusing on His mission, and whether it is good or bad, as St. Paul says in Philippians chapter 4 verse 12, whether I have eaten little or more, whether the circumstances are good or bad, in everywhere I have learned to live my life. I can do everything through Christ who strengthens me. And I go to strengthen the world. I am here on the mission to strengthen the world, strengthen the people, give God to the world, give God to the people. Maybe only my light is burning. I need not bother about my light. I protect my light and I give light wherever there is no light. Lit every candle. I am not here to worry about, oh, I am alone, what will happen, even whether this light also will go off. The thought of the enemies are very strange. When God has given me the light, everywhere people are going through suffering, and it gives me, the other suffering makes me, a child is running and falling down, and it wants to get up and go. It is putting like this, putting down the mud, but suddenly it saw somebody noticed, then it begins to cry. Because somebody watched, it is crying. Otherwise, it is ready to run. The circumstances, people all around. So whatever they speak of you, whatever they think of you, know who are you in the Lord. We forget to sow the seed of God and do not allow that to grow. Though we have heard in the retreat, though we are hearing every day, why it is not growing? Suddenly so many thoughts come and disturb me. The evil thoughts, I have said no, I will commit my life for God. Suddenly something else is coming. Why? How can I avoid it? Sometime at sleep, I don't get enough sleep. So many unwanted things come and trouble me. How to overcome it? The Lord is teaching us. So He says in Ephesians 6:12, it is not your wife, it is not your husband, it is not somebody is troubling you. No, it is not the flesh and blood in which we are fighting. The enemy,
The enemy enters into the mind of your husband and disturb you. The enemy enters into the mind of the wife and disturb the family. The enemy enters into somebody else and coming and disturbing everybody. So the enemy is roaring like a lion, whom I can catch and swallow them.